Hi guys, my name is Neha Gupta and I am back with the current affairs for September 30, 2020. So this is the last day of this month and I have a lot of interesting news for you guys. So quickly discuss those news. But before that, I would like to tell you to subscribe to our channel and join the Telegram channel in order to enjoy the free quizzes. As well as if you like this video, then do hit the like button as well. And now it's time for us to discuss the table of contents. So what are the things that we are going to discuss in this video? First, we will be discussing about the rankings given by Financial Times for management institutes. Then a new vertical created by Ministry of External Affairs. Then we will be discussing about a state scheme. Then about the chairman of Telecom Regulatory Authority of India. Then we will be discussing about another state scheme. So quite a lot of news which are very important for examination point of view. So do listen to me, do listen to this video till the end so that you do not miss out on important information. So this is our first question. How many Indian institutes have been ranked in the top 100 of Financial Times Masters in Management 2020 ranking? So first and foremost thing that we need to consider here is that this ranking is only for the management universities. The name itself is suggesting. Which organization releases it? It's Financial Times, which is a very reputed newspaper as well. Now, let's discuss the answer of this question. So which five, I have told you the answers. So it is five. A total number of five Indian institutes of management have been ranked in this ranking. So which are those five institutes? Let's have a glance over it. So in this table, I have mentioned all the institutes rank wise, and you can yourself see that Indian Institute of Management located in Ahmedabad is the highest ranked institute among other Indian institutes. And what is the global rank of IIM Ahmedabad? It is 20. Which institute succeeds IIM Ahmedabad? It is Calcutta. Then we have SP Jain Institute, IIM Bangalore, and IIM Udaipur. So these are the global ranks of these institutes. Now the thing that we need to pay attention to is this SP Jain Institute of Management and Research, which is a new entry in 2020 list. So do remember this thing because it can be asked in the examination. So now we have discussed how many Indian institutes were there. So we already know that which Indian institute is at the highest rank among other institutes. Now guys, do you know which institute is the world's top ranker? So it is University of St. Gallen in Switzerland. So do remember the country as well because it can also be asked in the examination. The examiner can put the question in this way that University of St. Gallen has topped this Financial Times Masters in Management ranking 2020. So tell us in which country does it located? So it is very, does it belong to? So it is very important for us to know the answer of that question as well. So do remember. Now the next thing that we need to discuss about this ranking is how many total universities were assessed by this ranking. So it is 100. Then the number of parameters. So it is 23. So the total institutes were ranked on 23 parameters. So that was all about this question. And I hope that I'm clear till now. In case you have any kinds of doubt, you can mention it in the comment section below. And let's quickly discuss our question number two, which is about the head of Oceania vertical of Ministry of External Affairs. So the question is asking us that which of the following is the head of the Oceania vertical of Ministry of External Affairs. So the answer of this question is option D, Rinat Sandhu. She is the head of this Oceania department. Now, what is this vertical? This vertical is for promoting India's neighborhood first policy in the Oceania region. Now, what is neighborhood first policy? Neighborhood first policy of India is to strengthen bilateral, cultural, economical, political ties of India with the neighborhood, with the neighboring countries like Sri Lanka, Bhutan, Maldives, Thailand, etc., etc. So, under this neighborhood policy, this Oceania division has been set up. The second important thing about this this division is that this division subsumes or includes Indo-Pacific vertical of Ministry of External Affairs as well as Southeast Asian vertical. So what is the meaning of this thing? The meaning here is that all the operations of Ministry of External Affairs in Indo-Pacific region and in Southeast Asian region have now been integrated under this Oceania division. So Oceania division is the head department under which these two verticals will operate. Now, you must be thinking about this Oceania vertical or this Oceania region. So quickly have a glance over it. Now guys, I have taken this map from a website called Maps of World, which is a branch of Maps of India. So this is basically an NPO website from where I have taken this map. So do not take it literally. Do not remember the cities with their locations, with the locations mentioned in this picture. Why have I taken this picture here? The purpose is to give you an idea of Oceania region in broad. So, which countries are there in Oceania region? So, this is a map of Australia and Oceania. And these are the countries which are being targeted by India through its Oceania vertical. From this map, you can yourself decipher that it is Australia and these are the islands which comprise of Oceania region. So, this is the authentic map of Oceania and Australia, which I have taken from Google Maps. From here, we will try to locate the countries. We will try to locate the broad area that India is targeting. So from Thailand, through this Oceania vertical, India is targeting countries from Thailand till this area, including New Zealand and Australia. So this is the broad area, this is the broad region in which India is planning to strengthen its ties under its neighborhood first policy. So that is all we need to discuss, we need to keep in mind about this new Oceania vertical. Do remember the head of this this vertical as well. Now I have a question for you guys. You have to tell me that who is the Minister of External Affairs in the comment section below. I hope that all of my students would know the answer of this question. It is just a quick lemon test for you. So do mention your answers in the comment section below. Now the next question is about a state scheme, which is Mukhyamantri Kisan Kalyan Yojana. So under this question, we have been asked about the amount, how much amount will be dispersed under the Mukhyamantri Kisan Kalyan Yojana of Madhya Pradesh. Now guys, do you see that we have been given the state in the question itself? So the level of question has been made more difficult. That is why I am repeatedly saying that do pay attention to the little details as well. So in this question, the answer is ₹4,000. Now, under this scheme, basically this scheme is on the lines of PM Kisan Samman Nidhi Yojana. Can you guys tell me that what this Kisan Samman Yojana is about? Okay, let me tell you that under this PM Kisan Samman Nidhi Yojana, the central government transfers an annual amount of ₹6,000 to the bank account of farmers in three equal installments of 2000 each. So this Mukhyamantri Kisan Kalyan Yojana also aims to disperse 4000 rupees annually in two installments. So how much amount will the farmers of Madhya Pradesh will get? It is 10,000. I hope I am clear with this equation, and if you have any kind of doubt, you can, I am again repeating this thing, that you can ask me in the comment section as well as on the Telegram channel. So do not forget this thing. In Madhya Pradesh, farmers will get 6,000 of central scheme and 4,000 under the state scheme. That was all about this scheme, and now we will be quickly moving on to our next question. But before that, I have a question for you guys. You have to tell me that who is the chief minister of Madhya Pradesh. Do tell me your answers. Now we have come to our next question, which is about the who has been appointed as the new chairman of Telecom Regulatory Authority of India. So what are the keywords? Chairman and Telecom Regulatory Authority of India. Now guys, let me tell you that in the magazine Spotlight, we have a total of 8 sections, and among those sections we have a section called appointments. I find most of my students complaining about the facts, the number of facts in the magazine. So let me tell you that how can you remember appointments easily. There are only 3 keywords in a sentence of an appointment, and those 3 keywords are: first, the name of the person; second keyword is the designation; and third is the company name. So here also we have 3 keywords. The answer is P.D. Wagela. So P.D. Wagela is the first keyword, second keyword is the chairman, third keyword is Telecom Regulatory Authority of India. So in this manner you can easily cover up the current affairs mentioned in Spotlight. I hope that it will help you in remembering the things better. And there was nothing to discuss more in the previous question. That is why I have quickly jumped on to this last question. So this last question is about the state. Which state has launched the Paryatan Sanjeevani scheme? First of all, what is the scheme about? Paryatan is tourism. Paryatan refers to tourism. Sanjeevani refers to lifeline or a life elixir. That's a life medicine, life-saving medicine. So Sanjeevani is basically a life-saving medicine, and the scheme does not need any elaboration. So from this, I hope that the purpose of the scheme is clear. So the purpose is to revive the tourism sector of the state. And now, which state are we talking about? Out of these 5 options, we have Assam. That is our answer. So Assam has launched this scheme. Under the scheme, Assam government will give loans between the range of 1 to 20 lakhs to local youth in order to promote tourism in the state, which was quite affected by COVID-19. I would say the most affected sector in the world is tourism itself from the COVID-19. And in order to revive this sector, only loans will be given. Do remember the amount as well. So we have covered everything about this scheme. Now, Assam CM. Who is the Assam CM? You have to tell me in the comment section below. I am keeping it a guess. I am hiding the name of the CM from you guys because I want to know this from you guys. So Assam CM has also launched another scheme which is named as Paryatan Sarathi. Paryatan is tourism, Sarathi is the carrier. So what is the purpose of this scheme? The scheme aims to promote tourism, to inform the people who are coming, inform basically the tourist. So this scheme aims to inform tourists about the tourist location in the state. That is the one line purpose of this scheme, and that is all we have to discuss about this scheme from the exam point of view. And now our session comes to an end. Do tell me how much did you like this session in the comment section below. And if you have any kinds of suggestion, then also tell me in the comment section. And do not forget to subscribe as well as like this video. Thank you so much. Come back again tomorrow at the same time, same place. Thank you.